Addressing opposition members of parliament during a workshop, the chairperson of the National Planning Authority, Joseph Muvawala, advised parliament to disband all sectoral committees, saying they are irrelevant to the program-based budgeting, which was adopted by government. Currently, parliament has 15 sectoral committees whose main mandate is to scrutinize budgets of different sectors.
The PSST has already written to parliament regarding the sectoral committees, and parliament has come back to advise the PSST that actually it is your role to make changes to the PFM Act. Sectoral committees are provided for in the law, PFM Act, and therefore changing them requires changing the law. And the person who proposes changes to the laws is not parliament. It's government. So we are now in the process of making those proposals. We need program committees.
Sectoral committees are established under Rule 175, and their membership is designated by party whips at the beginning of every session of parliament on basis of the party or organization representation in parliament, and phasing them out calls for an amendment of the law. With a shift from sectoral-based budgeting to the new budgeting approach that focuses on programs instead of sector, the Minister of State for Planning, Amos Lugolobi, says the composition of the parliamentary committee has to change to fit into the new system.
Parliament to be able to scrutinize the budget more effectively, they should accordingly align their committees to the programming system. Because before we are following sectors, the sector-based approach. Now we are facing program-based approach. So they should form committees based on the programs that we have. For example, we have a program called agro-industrialization, wherein you have agriculture and industry. It means that before you had a committee on industry, you also had a committee on agriculture. Now these two should collapse into one committee responsible for agro-industrialization. We should not have two committees. We should have one committee to see the integration between agriculture and industry. Because whatever you produce in agriculture has got to be processed and marketed. That's why we are following this program-based budgeting system, so that people are able to see, is what we produce being processed? If not, why?
However, lawmakers contend that phasing out sectoral committees alone will not smoothen implementation of the program based on budgeting, which is seen as a remedy for duplication of activities if government ministries which implement the budget are not realigned.
Because if you come up with a program-based approach, it implies that if you're looking at agro-industrialization, you should have one minister for that. You should have one minister for human capital development. Why then do you have then 10 ministers when the program is one? So if everyone, that's why I say there is no clear-cut operationalization or implementation framework.
Well, I think in the long term, I think the chief executive, the president, may have to look at that, the relevance of doing that. If that is the way to go.
Muvawala also challenged MPs on their bottleneck affecting service delivery, quoting much time spent by government agencies discussing expenditure during the budgeting process rather than focusing on revenue mobilization strategies.
This parliament spends its time discussing expenditure all the time. When did you ever discuss revenue? It is a general problem in government. Even in the meetings where we sit, Dr. Globa can tell you, we never spend 40 minutes discussing revenue. But our appetite is to discuss expenditure. As a country, we need to change our mindset. There is a revenue mobilization strategy of government. I don't know whether it has been brought to parliament, whether you are aware about it.
Meanwhile, opposition legislators faulted the National Planning Authority for misleading government with the parish development model, whose implementation has faced a lot of impediments. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.